You're listening to the audio production of Clarity in Crisis, Leadership Lessons from the CIA by Marc Polymeropoulos, published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by Tom Parks. After crosses and losses, men grow humbler and wiser. Benjamin Franklin. Preface. Are you looking for a leadership book filled with academic concepts, eloquent and research-based notions, and lessons imparted by an intimidating and egocentric leader who knows exactly how to be successful because he's never failed? If so, please keep looking. This book isn't for you. I'm not the stereotypical CIA officer of the movies or books. I don't carry a leather-bound briefcase filled with high-tech spy gear, drive an exotic sports car, carry a gun around town, or stand 6 feet tall wearing a sharp blazer with a menacing expression on my face. My voice is loud, and my laughter is even louder. Being of Greek heritage, that's the only tone we have, and we embrace it fully. And I have a terrible tendency to interrupt, which drives my friends and family crazy. I'm working on fixing that, but it's a tough row to hoe for a type A personality. I'm that guy wearing a t-shirt and pair of jeans, driving in my Jeep Wrangler with 35-inch tires and a lift kit, who volunteers to mow the lawn at the local high school baseball field where his son plays. I'm that guy who melts every time his little girl, now a fine-grown woman, calls to update him from college on how her day is going. The guy who excuses himself while on the phone with a journalist from the Washington Post because he has to go put the laundry into the dryer or do the dishes. Self-importance and ego are not part of my vocabulary. If I had to choose a theme song to play in the background of my life, it wouldn't be the fast-paced, loud, and energetic tempo of the Mission Impossible soundtrack. It would be a reassuring, comfortable, and familiar country song by Kenny Chesney that talks about pickup trucks, dirt roads, and the importance of family. You're not going to find me in a freshly pressed polo shirt at the golf course. I don't even play golf. Rather, I'm that guy in the RV at the Daytona 500 or sitting in the bleachers with my family at our beloved Washington Nationals baseball games. Don't waste your time looking for me at the most pretentious and overpriced restaurant in the nation's capital, because I'll be at my favorite dive bar in Northern Virginia, the Vienna Inn, eating chicken wings and drinking beer with my buddies. A baseball hat with the Vienna Inn logo that I wore in Afghanistan for an entire year hangs on the wall. Go see for yourself. It's really there. Yet I do have a refined side, which comes out at times. I have 2 degrees from Cornell University and have traveled the world twice over. I've briefed in the Situation Room at the White House, sat with kings and prime ministers, belong to a country club, mainly for the bar by the pool, have a 20-year-old Rolex I can pull out on demand, and have attended more fancy diplomatic receptions than I care to remember. I'm an immigrant, born outside this country, and proudly worked for the CIA for 26 long years before my body finally gave out and I had to retire. So, what are you going to find in this book? I will present you 9 leadership principles told through my personal stories at CIA, stories that I have never publicly revealed before and that will become your secret weapons to rise to the top of the ranks in whatever profession you are in. So, welcome. I promise you will enjoy the ride. Introduction. The truth shall make you free. In high school travel baseball, parents lie and brag about their sons, coaches assuage the crazed parents to try and keep the peace, and social media is the epitome of wild exaggeration, where every young catcher has a 1.9 pop time and a 15-year-old pitcher throws a 90-mile-per-hour fastball. But the players themselves know the truth. Who really is solid, both in the locker room and on the field? Or who has a team-first attitude, and who is only in it for themselves. At CIA, the same applies. We lie for a living, especially to foreigners. On the other hand, we must never lie to our colleagues, drawing a fine line of acceptable behavior. The truth, your integrity, is what sets you apart, as you so often operate on your own with no supervision other than your conscience or your God or both. A clear mind from practicing honesty will allow you to sleep at night. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. This is the biblical verse, John chapter 8, verse 32, etched in the stone wall of the lobby at the Central Intelligence Agency headquarters at Langley, Virginia. It was former CIA Director Alan Dulles, son of a minister, who wanted these words to become the motto of the CIA, as they mirror the main core value of what the agency stands for. Discover the truth and share it with the president, no matter what the implications would be for politics or political party. It is a professional ethos that includes the core values of service, integrity, excellence, courage, teamwork, and stewardship, and that is talked about often and is deeply ingrained in every CIA officer from the very first steps they take into the CIA headquarters. These words are sacrosanct to me. I have lived by this ethos for 26 years, my entire career at CIA. My name is Marc Polymeropoulos. I was an operations officer by trade and one of CIA's most highly decorated field officers of my generation. I failed far more than I succeeded, and my ability to handle adversity was, ultimately, a key reason for my success. I am the recipient of the Distinguished Intelligence Medal, the Intelligence Medal of Merit, the Intelligence Commendation Medal, and the Distinguished Career Intelligence Medal. That's a lot of shiny hardware sitting on a shelf gathering dust in my basement, earned with blood and sweat from beating the pavement, conducting tough street operations in some nasty places, and against some truly fearsome adversaries. My last position was overseeing all CIA clandestine operations in the Europe and Eurasia Mission Center. For the majority of my career, my specialty was working in the Middle East, both across the Levant and the Gulf, and also in the conflict zones of Iraq, Afghanistan, and North Africa. When I retired from the senior intelligence service ranks, my equivalent military grade was a 4-star general. I have led thousands of the men and women of the CIA for the last 2.5 decades in numerous clandestine operations and covert actions. Due to the very nature of my job, I've spent my life in the shadows. None of these operations were attributed to me or my teams at the agency, but the results of our work landed on the front pages of the New York Times and the Washington Post, and some were covered live by every media outlet on the planet. For this and for many other reasons, I can say with great pride that I have had the unique experience of witnessing history and often making history from the center stage of the world. What an amazing journey my life and career have been. I'm honored, fortunate, and indeed humbled to have been given the opportunity to serve with the men and women of the CIA, my home, for 26 years. The CIA. The Central Intelligence Agency is our nation's first line of defense. Like any other government agency, it was not built overnight. It went through several versions until on July 26, 1947, President Harry S. Truman signed the National Security Act, officially making the CIA what it is today. But before the CIA, there was the Organization of Strategic Services, also known as the OSS. Founded in 1942 and headed by the great General William Donovan, the OSS operated behind enemy lines during World War II and was also responsible for propaganda operations. Some of its most famous exploits included the insertion of JEDBRA teams, 3-man units dropped into France in 1944 to help the resistance against Nazi occupation. The OSS was disbanded in 1945 after the United States dropped the atomic bombs on Japan. Many in the U.S. government at the time, including Truman, thought such a spy organization was unsavory. But no president wants to be surprised in the middle of the night, so wisdom won the day. That original spirit of the OSS is still alive and can be seen with long-standing and oft-publicized CIA deployments to war zones such as Afghanistan and Iraq. Today, the CIA has five basic components referred to as directorates. Each directorate plays a critical role in the intelligence cycle. The process of collecting, analyzing, and disseminating intelligence to top U.S. government officials. The basic mission of the CIA is simple and straightforward. Collect and analyze foreign intelligence to assist the president and other policymakers in the U.S. government in making national security decisions. Most of the work performed at CIA is never seen by the general public. So it should come as no surprise that the work done by the Directorate of Science and Technology, DSNT, is highly classified. The men and women, the scientists, engineers, and technical experts in the DSNT produce technology so advanced, it's out of the science fiction genre. Think back to a James Bond movie and the work developed by the Q branch. What our men and women do is even more impressive. The use of science and technology is critical to the intelligence process, and the DSNT's mission is to attack intelligence problems with cutting-edge technical solutions to help protect the nation. The Directorate of Support, DS, provides CIA personnel 24/7 with logistical support, medical services, security protection, and safe facilities, just to name a few of its mission-critical roles. Our operations officers from the Directorate of Operations, DO, collect the intelligence by recruiting foreigners, our agents, to provide non-public secret information about their countries, which is what I did for 23 of the 26 years of my career. The Directorate of Digital Innovation, DDI, is the agency's newest directorate focused on accelerating innovation across the agency's mission activities with cutting-edge digital and cyber tradecraft and IT infrastructure. Our analysts, my original tribe for the first three of my 26 years at CIA, from the Directorate of Analysis, DA, then use human intelligence, along with other sources of collection, such as imagery from satellites, signals intelligence from intercepted phone calls or coded messages, and open-source information from the translation of foreign media, to formally assess what is happening on a given issue and perhaps what will occur in the future. Such assessments are free of political bias and are provided in written or oral form to policymakers. Finally, at times, the CIA is specifically and lawfully tasked by the White House to undertake covert action, which are activities that the CIA may take in other countries to accomplish a U.S. foreign policy objective without the hand of the U.S. government becoming known. This is the stuff of the CIA mystique, and some of it is quite controversial, such as, and this happened many decades ago, overthrowing Latin American governments and conducting seemingly bizarre mind control experiments. Truth be told, those operations are far in the rearview mirror, and I had no experience with such activities. I was involved in multiple covert action programs, primarily in the counterterrorism arena. Some of these operations were the proudest events of my career and saved countless U.S. lives. We worked hand in glove with the military, and in particular U.S. Special Operations warriors, who were some of the finest and bravest Americans I've ever met. One of my favorite quotes is attributed to George Orwell, who I believe quite succinctly summed up the work of the CIA and U.S. military special operations teams fighting the war on terrorism. He stated, "People sleep peaceably in their beds at night only because rough men stand ready to do violence on their behalf." A glass paperweight with these words sits on my desk at home, even today. Diversity at CIA. Given the cultural fascination with the Central Intelligence Agency and people who work for it, I feel compelled to demystify stereotypical imagery and incorrect terminology associated with it. First of all, at CIA, we employ officers.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.